always been fascinated by fire ever since I was a child. I've been both afraid of it and drawn to it. It's very beautiful, but it's also very dangerous. I lived in a house that burned down, and that was a very terrifying thing. So that image of fire has stayed with me all my life. And when I came to put this collection of stories together, there were two or three stories which I had written already, which I realised had a common theme of fire. But the other thing that was interesting about it for me was that they became a metaphor, if you like, for the past, for the way that trouble lies in the past, things that we've tried to put behind us are actually embedded in the subconscious, and they can be quite dangerous when they come and confront you later on. My stories, the 11 stories in this book, are not the conventional short arc of the short story. I've been trying to do something else, which is a more layered kind of story, so that people's lives are compressed into stories of about 10 or 11,000 words. So in these stories, in almost all of these stories, the past is coming back, burning in the background. I've always been very interested in the French writer Marguerite Duras, who talks about writing coming out of the deep sleep of our lives. So many of my characters are confronted by something which is coming out of that deep sleep, the past behind them, and then something happens that they're confronted with some truth about themselves. And that can be dangerous and beautiful and frightening, all of those things. So those are the themes that run through these stories. They range from contemporary stories to stories about the historical past of New Zealand. The last story, which the title story is taken from, is called The Trouble with Fire. That is the title story, and it's about a colonial woman who goes out and burns the countryside, effectively for the fun of it, which is dreadful now because our beautiful country was once covered with beautiful forest, which has mostly been burned down to make way for farms. But she is drawn, like other characters, in a very literal sense, to making fire, to going out and setting fires alight. So I suppose there's a little bit of the arsonist in many of us. We want to blow things up, if you like. Yeah. There are also linked stories in which there is a group of three linked stories in which there is a secret in the past. Something happens in the 1930s. Something terrible on a farm. And on this particular farm, there are peat fires that burn beneath the surface of the earth. It's a little hard to explain, really, but peat is combustible. And so in the summer, beneath the ground, there would be fires. And so in this rather dark and smoking landscape, which is one which I know very well because my family farmed there for a time, something happens to a woman. And in the consecutive two stories, the event is explained or seen by two generations of people who are, so there are three retellings of the same story, but each from a different perspective.